Good morning and welcome to the Congregational South Dartmouth. We are an open and affirming congregation of the United Church of Christ, and we are so delighted to see you all gathered here this morning in our midst. So, welcome home.
Yay!
Today before I go on some visits with some people. So we do have that. And provided that all goes well today, which it feels like it will, we will be here next Sunday. And if it rains ever, we will let you know by 7:30 in the morning. We'll send out an email, let you know it's going to rain, and Sarah and I and probably Dave Nielsen will move into the sanctuary and do it live from there if it rains. So I've kind of laughed. I dreamed last night that one night it kind of rained, but not really. And I looked out my window and y'all were all sitting here with umbrellas. So stay tuned. You know, it'll be interesting. Are there any joys and concerns or any more announcements? Does the moderator have an announcement? You're standing there looking. No? Okay. Any joys and concerns at this time?
So we have a concern. The best man at our wedding, Brian's friend from high school, Rick Avini, passed away this week after a short but very intense battle with cancer. It was kind of a shock. He's in California, so we won't be able to attend any services. Please pray for him and his family.
Okay, and that's Rick, and he was the best man in your wedding.
Yes.
I also have prayers for Sheila on here, and then I have a Thanksgiving and joy for Winnie's third birthday. Any other joys and concerns? Yes, Susan?
Prayers for Hope. She fractured her wrist on Friday, and is probably going to be casted tomorrow.
Okay.
But she's doing well.
Okay.
Not so much.
Yes, Alice?
I have joys where I have a son that got married and another one that's engaged during all of this. And so love just abounds. And they all live with me for quite a while. which was wonderful to witness. And then there is the sadnesses, but understandable, of family members in their 80s and 90s who have passed away, and yes, the virus was the final dot. But boy, am I glad that I was able to share all the time, in general, my joys and having them in my life. And I think that is so important for us all to acknowledge every day of when we say we love you, why we love you today.
Yes, prayers for a friend and colleague of mine, Jim, who has been diagnosed with pancreatic cancer and possibly other cancer. And then a joy, it's my 11th wedding anniversary today.
Is it? Yeah. Oh, great. Any other? So if there are no other joys and concerns, remain seated and hear my words as I call us into worship this morning. The kingdom of God, you see, it is all around us. A mustard seed that someone took and sowed in their field, it is the smallest of all seeds, I tell you. But when it has grown, it is the greatest of shrubs and becomes a very large tree so that the birds can come and make nests in its branches. The kingdom of God is here all around us this morning. Yeast that a person took and mixed in with 3 measures of flour until it was all leavened. The kingdom of God is here all around us. Treasure hidden in a field, which someone found and hid and then joyfully sold all that they had so they could buy the field. The kingdom of God, it's here all around us, I tell you. A merchant in search of fine pearls or finding one of value sells all their possessions just for the one pearl. It's like the kingdom of God, which is all around us. So come, let us gather together this day and worship our Creator. Can you all hear me in the back? You can, okay. Let us pray. God of small seeds and mighty plants, you take our meager lives and with your love calls them to produce acts of loving kindness for you out in this world. You hear our cries and find us when we are lost and wandering in fear. You bring us home so that we may be restored and rejoice in your goodness. Help us, O God, to joyfully serve you all our days, knowing that you, O great love, are watching over us. Prepare our hearts for worship and sweep in and abide with us during this time. Amen. Hear now a word from the Gospel of Matthew, chapter 13, verses 31 through 33, and verses 44 through 52. Another story for you. God's kingdom is like a small pine nut that a farmer plants, or a mustard seed, one of those really small seeds. But in those years that pass, it will grow into a large tree, like even a large pine tree, and eagles will build nests in it. Another story, God's kingdom is like yeast that a woman works into the dough for dozens of loaves of barley bread and waits until the dough rises. God's kingdom is like a treasure hidden in a field for years and then accidentally found by a trespasser. The finder is ecstatic, what a find, and proceeds to sell everything he owns to raise money and buy the field. For God's kingdom's like a jewel merchant, hunting for the pearls, finding the flawless one and selling it. God's kingdom is also like a fish net, cast into the sea, catching all kinds of fish. And when it's full, it's hauled onto the beach. The good fish are picked out and put in a tub. Those unfit to eat. comes down on history. The angels will come and call the bad fish and throw them into the garbage. There'll be a lot of desperate complaining, but it won't do any good. And Jesus asked them, are you starting to get a handle on this? Are you starting to understand this? And they answered, yes. Jesus said, then you see how every student well-trained in God's kingdom is like the owner of a general store who can put his hands on anything you need, old or new, exactly when you need it. And that's the gospel of Matthew chapter 13 from the Message this morning. Let's pray. Creator God, let the words of our hearts and the meditations of our mouths always be acceptable in your sight, O Lord, our God. Amen. The scripture that we just heard today talks about the kingdom of God. When I was a little girl, I used to think that the kingdom of God was way up there somewhere. But then again, I also used to think that the divine was way up there too, someplace far away, distant. No longer. No longer do I believe like that. The kingdom of God, you see, it's right here. It's here now on earth. We even pray on earth as it is in heaven. And God, the great love, oh, you see, I believe the great love resides within us, abides with us, near us, always, not in some far away distant realm. I've heard some theologians refer to the kingdom as the kingdom. And I'll be honest with you all this morning, in the past when I've heard that, I've kind of rolled my eyes and thought, huh, kingdom. I may have dismissed the word in the past, but you see, I believe today is like no other day. These are unprecedented times, and I believe that the word kingdom fits today. Because if I were to ask some of you why you're here today, I imagine you might say this to me. I miss church. I miss seeing other church members. I miss community. I miss those that I know here. Kinfolk. The kingdom. At least that's what some of you have told me on phone calls and texts and emails. A few of you have had crises of faith and called me to come sit in a chair in your yard to talk the whole situation over, looking for answers in these days, looking for something constant. If you're here today and you are weary, maybe even weary of wearing a mask, if you're here today and you are confused, if you're here today and you are lonely, if you are here today and you have doubts about the Creator, any of that, you're in the right place. For you see, here in this place, on this holy ground, you will hear me reassure you over and over again that you are loved by the divine. And if you've listened to me in the years past, then you know that I'm going to remind you here in this space that we do not believe in an angry God. We do not believe in a God of fear, and we certainly do not do guilt in this place. A lot of people have had conversations with me along the lines of, is this God's will? I would gently urge you into pondering the thought that perhaps that's old thinking. New thinking would not ask why, but rather where do I see the divine reside in the chaos? For you see, there's been chaos since the beginning of time. Chaos in the garden. Chaos in the desert. Chaos in Jerusalem. Chaos in the Garden of Gethsemane. Chaos at the cross. chaos swirls around us always, always in some form or another. I think this has been a moment in time where we have begun to see how less important our church buildings are and just how crucial our church community is. I think it's been a moment in time where we have stopped running the rat race. We've jumped off the hamster wheel of life and sat down with loved ones to work on a puzzle. And yes, the loss of life during this time has been tragic and heartbreaking for certain. And God weeps with us in our grief over graduations and weddings that did not take place, or at least the way we thought they would. Memorial services that are on hold, gravesides limited to a few people. The Christ? The man from Nazareth? He knows of our grievances. He knows of our pain and of our losses. Each of you has been missed here in this space. And we celebrate your joys with you, the graduations, the new jobs, the babies born. I've often thought, what would I have said to you on March 8th had I have known it was our last Sunday service? What benediction would I have given at the Reverend Bob Boynton's memorial service, your pastor emeritus, on Thursday, March 12th? It was the last time people were gathered in the sanctuary. If I had known the pandemic was coming and in such a great extent, what would I have said to you? I think I would have said this, that God abides with you and resides with you in the darkness. The Christ knows of your anxiety and your worry. The Spirit hovers around you and over you. Be still in those moments and know that God will never forsake you nor leave you. Take time to be quiet and find peace at your very center. Take deep breaths and exhale. A walk, move around outside. Turn off the TV and the news and the internet. Seek peace. We will know of different days. God is present always. The church building has been closed, but we've been out in the world living out the gospel. In fact, the times during the pandemic that I've gone on Wednesdays to help feed the homeless with mobile ministries, it's been my church for the week. We will see if gathering outside like this can continue for the rest of the summer. We'll even throw in bulletins so it could be more interactive in the days ahead. This was our trial today. I believe in time we will be back in the building when science and medicine say it's safe. So, Kingdom of God, I'm delighted that you've gathered this day. Draw comfort, love, and strength from this time. Depart knowing that you are the beloved. God calls you the beloved. Rest in that peace, beloved. In that space of love, rest there this day. It's great to see your beloved faces. Welcome home. Welcome home. Thank you. great love. We give you thanks for the world that you hide like a treasure in our heart. For the leaven which is able to penetrate every area of our life. For the seed that is able to grow into a mighty plant or large tree. Help us to value everything you've given us to make following in the footsteps of Jesus of Nazareth our daily priority, to concentrate on sharing your love with all the world. We give you thanks for the wonders and the new things that you continue to do in our midst. We thank you for the guidance, the strength, the wisdom, the peace, the joy, the patience, and the gentleness that you bestow upon us through your Spirit. Help us to value both the old and the new and to lean into your kingdom, your kingdom. We pray for the people around us this day, for those who are upon our hearts and minds because of needs they have. We pray for someone in our congregation who will be having serious surgery this week on cancer in their leg. We pray for another among us who's recovering from heart surgery. We pray for those in our congregation who are undergoing treatments for cancer. We pray for those in our congregation with dementia and Alzheimer's who are separated from those they love and the places that care for them. We pray for all in our country who have passed away during this time. We lift up Rick Aveni, and give you thanksgiving for his life and prayers for his family and friends, and for the Mickelsons as they grieve this loss. We pray for Sheila, who's recently had a stroke, for Cynthia, who recently had a stroke. We give you thanksgiving for Winnie, for her third birthday. We pray for Connor, who has cancer, a small child. We lift up prayers for Hope and her broken wrist, that you would be with them. We give you thanksgiving that Alice's son got married and another got engaged. We lift up the memory of Alice's family members who passed away during this time. We pray for Brian's friend Jim with cancer. We give you thanksgiving and praise that today is Brian and Sharon's 11-year anniversary. Oh God, we thank you for their love. We pray for all the requests here among these people that are known only to you, that are held deep within their hearts. Bless those that are without this day, those without shelter, food, water, and appropriate medical care. Bless those sick in body, mind, and spirit. Bless the addicted and those recovering. We specifically pray for those who use our church home as their meeting base for their recovery. I pray your hand be upon them during this time. We ask you, O great love, to hear all these prayers in the name of the one who taught us to pray these words together in one voice this morning, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. So you can say it with me. Thy kingdom come.
Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen.
This has been wonderful. It's been great to see you. What a great space we have. We should give thanksgiving for such beautiful land that we have here at this church as well. So receive now the benediction. Go from this place and seek to be the light of Christ in the world. Because the world so desperately needs the light of Christ, and the world so desperately needs love. Go in peace, and may the blessings of God the Creator, Jesus the Christ, and the Holy Spirit be upon you and guard you and keep you all your days on this earth. God's richest blessings.